This is Masterpiece.
Nurse!
He needs an ambulance, Mama.
Just hold my hand. Let him come home to his family.
I want best behavior.
Papa!
You're his rock.
Can't my last victory be one of peace?
Michael Gambon heads an all-star cast.
Face them down, Winston.
I can face anything with you.
Churchill's Secret, tonight on Masterpiece.
Too close. He found him a bore. Smiling distance. 5 minute warning.
Let's up the yard.
I've got to go, Rosie. I'm late for John.
Millie, please.
It's Mr. Donaldson. I don't know what's happening.
Dr. Stroud. He'll be on his way out, heading for Mason's Arms on Parade Street, and where that?
Run, Rosie.
Signor Di Gasperi, in drinking to your health and to that of the whole Italian nation, I am mindful that the first people to conquer these islands in 43 AD, we British have long memories, you know, were the Romans. Men from your country built a better way of law and order, a land free from barbarism, and gave us hot baths, which throughout my long and not uneventful life, I have, as my wife would confirm, partaken twice a day.
Thank you. I'm sorry, Miss John.
He'll see more than enough of me when we're married.
I don't know what I'm going to do when you're in Australia.
Well, I've not gone yet.
I just panicked in there.
Don't blame yourself. We did everything we could. Everyone has their time.
We who have lived through two terrible wars and now live in the precarious days of the hydrogen bomb, understand the need to build a lasting peace between nations. Therefore, at the Bermuda Conference this summer, I will seek American support for my personal approach to secure peace with the new leaders of Soviet Russia in post-Stalin days. And in the spirit of peace, I give you Signor De Gasperi and the nation of Italy.
Signor De Gasperi and the nation of Italy.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Prime Minister invites you to retire to the state drawing room.
Prime Minister, are you all right? A glass of water, perhaps.
Would you excuse me for just one moment?
Was I lapped up? Was I lapped up?
Were you, Watson?
The
speech went very well, sir. Are you all right?
Darling?
Yes, darling. Would you excuse me?
Christopher, don't let the waiters in.
Of course.
Winston, do you think you're able to stand up?
He needs an ambulance, Mama.
He needs his doctor. Get Lord Moran, Jock. Make our excuses to the Italians and clear the house.
What Italians?
Just hold my hand, Winston. Just hold my hand.
And would you give his apologies to Gasperi and get them to leave?
Of course. Rap?
Jock? What's going on?
We've got the Americans on the phone, Rab, and we could do with clearing the house, actually. Would you give Christopher a hand?
Thanks.
Trying all night, Charles. Where the hell have you been?
Sussex. Just got your message half an hour ago. What's happened?
Lord Moran, the Prime Minister.
Good morning, Winston. How are you feeling?
Thinking about Bermuda.
Let's get you just sitting down, shall we?
Where exactly is it?
Not my subject, I'm afraid. Just sitting on the edge. On the edge. That's good. Good, gentlemen. How are you feeling?
Good.
Now, once more, could you just grasp my fingers here, just there, and with this hand, with your left. That's good.
Where are my cufflinks?
You're wearing them, Winston.
Ah.
I'm sure it's just tiredness.
He's exhausted, Mary. He's 78.
And being foreign secretary as well while Eaton's ill.
What's his first appointment?
Cabinet at 11.
Cancel it.
I think we should wait for Lord Moran's report.
Could you raise both arms for me?
If I must.
Raise them both. Be gently, good. Put both arms, Winston. Both arms. Both, yes, good. Good, that's fine. Now, just relax, just drop. Now, do you remember a few years back, you found it difficult to squeeze the paint out of the tubes?
The Monte Carlo clot.
Well, this could be the same.
Well, she gave me a pill. She put me up in Monte Carlo with your red pill.
Yes, well, I'll give you something, but really must rest up till we find out what's going on. Very nice. I like to be serenaded when I'm working. Now, the brain is a very delicate and complicated thing. Billions of connections.
Billions? Very precise. Is that a medical term?
No. Yeah. Behave.
If my brain's got billions of connections, then quite a few will still be working. Yeah. I've only ever needed half a dozen to take a cabinet meeting.
What did the Americans want last night?
Nothing serious. Eisenhower wanted to go through the social arrangements.
A little bird tells me Morin is here.
Yes, just routine.
He's an old man, Chris. We love him, but it's time he stood aside. Let Eden take the strain, for his own good, as well as the party's.
But Anthony's in no shape to take over at the moment, is he? He's in America getting his gallbladder fixed. Your man's sick of me, Winston.
He'll be all right after he's been under the knife.
And when is that?
Tonight.
Is the Bermuda conference first?
Fourth, Prime Minister. Korea first, then German elections, then commercial television.
Stay close.
Let's let them in.
Is it another stroke?
That's what I suspect. Now, he needs complete rest, so this Bermuda trip next week is perfect. 3 weeks at sea, no distractions.
I'll go and see him.
I'm afraid he's taking cabinet.
You let him take cabinet?
I couldn't stop him.
He's your patient, Charles. It's your job to stop him.
There's nothing I could do. There was just one other thing. He was singing.
Singing?
Yeah. I'm forever blowing bubbles.
The thing to stress in Bermuda, Prime Minister, is that your approach will not be seen as unilateral. If they see it as a personal crusade by yourself, they'll block it. But it has to be presented as a united diplomatic effort.
Obviously. What's next?
They're on to Bermuda now.
That's more than halfway through.
It seems to be going smoothly, as far as we can tell.
What's he got for the rest of the day?
We've cancelled the German trade lunch, so Prime Minister's questions at 2, which we hope he'll be all right for.
What if he isn't? What if he starts singing in front of the whole house? Charles is recommending complete rest, so I'm taking him away today to where he'll be properly looked after.
I suppose we could say he's gone to Chequers early to prepare for the summit.
No. You can't get away from anything there. I'm taking him home.
Millie, there's a policeman from the special branch at Upstrand. They want to see you.
Me?
Going.
Yeah.
priorities on my desk, and the rest over there. Hello? We've arrived. Start putting the calls through.
Nurse Appleyard?
Ah, yes. Follow me. I haven't much time, I'm afraid.
Oh, thank you.
This is her ladyship's bedroom and is strictly off limits, as is the library and the office beyond. His studio's at the back, where he paints, but I don't imagine he'll be doing much of that this weekend.
Where who paints?
Have you signed the act?
I don't know. I signed something those men wouldn't speak to me.
You signed the Official Secrets Act, which means that any discussion of this assignment anywhere, ever, will be severely punished. Do you understand? Bedroom and study are through here. To see his bedroom?
Excuse me, Mr.
Colville.
Colville. Who lives here?
The Prime Minister. He'll be here within the hour. The Prime Minister has had a mild stroke. You're here to look after him for a few days.
Why me?
I've been asking myself the same question, Miss Appleyard.
Wait. I can't nurse him in here. It's too small. I need to be able to get round both sides of the bed. I want the bed moved into this bigger room.
His head, Clemmy. That's it. Good.
Darling.
Dive on quickly as you can, sir. We're almost there.
Any minute now.
You're gonna think I'm a bit daft.
What?
Will you mind I didn't vote for him?
Nurse, quickly.
Oh, take his weight. Hey. Arm under his shoulder.
Sergeant. Thank you.
Mind his arm.
Gently with
him. I'll take his head. Get his feet. And round.
Thank you, gentlemen. Some privacy, please.
Bad, is it?
Shh.
Charles.
Heart is struggling. Circulation is very poor. He may not last the weekend.
Jock, will you give me a hand with the boxes?
How is he? What?
They had a difficult journey. I'm so sorry, Mary.
Have you told anybody?
Nobody.
Why has his bed been moved in here?
It's easier for us to attend to him.
What happened, Charles?
I suspect he's had a more severe stroke.
And will he be all right? Tell me the truth.
If he regains consciousness at all, he may suffer paralysis and brain damage, and there is also the risk of heart failure.
Oh, Papa.
The Prime Minister wasn't in the house this afternoon because he was preparing for his voyage to Bermuda, Stephen.
No. Lord Moran's visit to Downing Street is a routine checkup before such a long journey.
Soames. Christopher Soames.
Chartwell.
I don't know. I'll have to ask Mr. Colville.
Thank you, Steve.
1 minute, please. Downing Street want to confirm the travel arrangements for Bermuda. He'll get back to you. Later on.
I want to let the Americans know first if he isn't making Bermuda.
The minute you do that, everyone will know he's sick.
Moran thinks he's dying. We have to decide what we're going to tell the press. Hello, Express. Lord Beaverbrook's office, please.
Could you give this message to Lord Bracken?
I don't care. The Prime Minister wants to speak to him. Just put him through.
This is the Prime Minister's parliamentary private secretary.
Which theatre? Savoy. No, I'll do it myself, thank you.
Talk, which telephone can I use?
You can use one of mine.
The message reads urgent. The Prime Minister requires your immediate presence tonight at Chartwell.
Pimlico 3322.
Oh, that's it. Thank you.
Piccadilly 8000, please. Savoy concierge.
Diana? It's Mary.
What are you doing?
His left side is very weak. I feel that working the muscles might encourage better blood flow and maybe improve his chances of recovery. At the very least, it must be comforting to be touched.
Christopher.
Operation Hope Not.
His funeral.
This.
The only precedent was the Duke of Wellington's. It
It was the Queen's personal suggestion that we base it on that.
Was the name your idea?
Afraid so. The Lords of the Press. We'll see them in the studio. And we don't want Lady Churchill disturbed.
Mm. Look at them. Who? The cronies. Gathering at the deathbed of their leader. Thank you. I'll sit with him now. I won't go far.
I got your cloak and dagger summons, Jock, and I thought either Winston's been a communist spy all along or he's dying. Which is it?
My lords, if you'd like to step this way, we can use the studio.
Fear of being given one of his paintings as a gift. Is Winston joining us?
No.
If Winston is dying, we'll have to pull the morning editions. I need a telephone.
Max, please. At the moment, we don't know anything for sure.
We know enough.
We are asking that you wait.
We think that's what he'd want.
To gag us.
Only until the situation is clearer.
It is impossible to make a proper diagnosis until he comes round.
What if a mirror sniffs something? They'd be only too happy to report a headless government in crisis.
That's why you're here, to make sure that doesn't happen.
What about Eden? Do we know how his operation went?
I've got a man at the hospital.
So have I. But without Winston and with Eden out of the running, you've got no one.
Maybe a caretaker government for 6 months under Lord Salisbury.
Are you serious? He'd have a general election in a week.
This is why the party needs more time, Max.
Nurse! 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 He's choking. He swallowed his tongue. Take a breath. Right, let's get him up. There you go.
What about the cabinet?
A rab will inform them in the morning.
In Parliament?
No plans to tell them.
I know the Constitution's not written down, but you're trampling all over it.
Lord Moran, the Prime Minister's regaining consciousness.
Will you excuse me, gentlemen?
Find out about Eden. Mm. I'm going to see Winston.
Dixer, red. Latin, Winston?
Sir, my mind hasn't gone.
That's the last thing that we'll pack up. Shall we just step outside?
No.
Very weak, and has a loss of sensation on the left side, You're vulnerable to further strokes.
Tell me, am I dying, Charles?
I don't know.
Max. Max?
Yes, my friend.
Anthony.
We're finding that out now, Winston.
Give me time. Give me time. Please. For me.
I'll talk to the others.
Thank you.
How is he?
Conscious, but very weak. His speech was hard to understand, but his meaning was as clear as ever. How's Eden?
There's no question of his returning to public life before the autumn.
So we'll need to keep quiet about this for longer than a few days. Maybe the whole summer, if Winston hangs on.
Ministers will still need decisions from the Prime Minister. How will you handle that?
Rabble hold the fort with Cabinet.
As for decisions, Christopher and I know what he wants, so I think we can make it work. He was going on holiday after Bermuda anyway, so if he pulls through, he can carry on.
And no one will be any the wiser.
And do what exactly? Drag himself back to Westminster half-paralyzed, slurring his words?
If he regains enough strength, Clemmy, I know he still hopes to lead the way to the end of the Cold War.
What about his family? We don't want a man crippled with illness who's worked himself to death. Don't you think we deserve some time with him?
Clemmy.
No. You've kept him propped up on pills for years, Charles. If you have any love for him, if any of you do, you would get him to stop. You would let him come home to his family.
Winston has two families, one at Westminster.
He has one family, Max. He's given enough. We both have.
We'll keep this quiet one day at a time. I think we all want the same thing here. Just time for him to recover so he can make up his own mind. Don't you agree?
A toast to Winston.
To Winston.
And our country.
Our country.
What's your name?
Nurse Appleyard, sir.
No, not your rank. Your name.
Millie.
Minnie.
We'll talk in the morning.
Fine, fine.
Running the world on our own, then.
So it would seem.
Do you have family?
My mum and dad. And my fiancé. Although he's not family yet.
What's his name?
John.
Well, this is our family. Diana. Sarah. Randolph.
And that's Mrs. Holmes?
No. Mary wasn't born then. When are you getting married?
We're going to emigrate to Australia. He's going in a few weeks and then I'll join him. We plan to marry there.
And start your family?
In time.
Someone help me with this silly thing. It's stuck.
Diana? Oh.
Thank you. How is he?
Well, he's much better today, actually. I thought Sarah was supposed to be on that train.
She missed it, I'm afraid. We're going to have to wait for her. Where's Duncan?
He's away, of course. I tried to telephone him first thing, but he wasn't where he said he would be, and... I was thinking, on the train, should I board the children?
Better not. I've been keeping Nicholas and Emma out of the way.
Well, I did think about it.
Take it.
She'll think you're moving in.
I only just got back from Los Angeles. I haven't had time to unpack.
I thought you'd both stay with Christopher and me down at the farm.
I can't do that. I've got to get back for the children. Oh, I'm dreading this.
Hello, Mrs. Stacy.
Shh. Mama's sleeping. I'll let her know you're here.
Jock?
Spider emerges from his lair.
Diana? Sarah?
Do spiders have lairs?
Let's just neaten you up a bit, shall we? Make you presentable. Oh, here they are. Please expect me.
Papa? It's Diana.
Puppy kitten.
Puppy kitten, yes. And the mule is here too.
Hello, Papa.
She only flew in from America 2 days ago.
Yes. Children.
Children, no. I didn't bring the children. It's only me. I thought the children would be too much. He wants to hold your hand.
We all hope to see you up and about soon, Papa. America. Oh. America was a great success.
Your husband.
Tony, Tony's doing okay. He's directing television now.
Not a good time.
No, it's not.
I want to see him.
Come on, Diana. We'll come back soon, Papa.
We've only just arrived.
Well, he wants to work. See you later. Well, it's past 12 and I need a drink. What are you doing?
Making breakfast for Mama. She was up all night. How is he?
He looked terrible and sounded worse.
Ooh, olives. Who wants a dirty martini?
Yes, please.
Ice?
Try the dining room.
It's here.
I've got the jug. Is Randolph coming?
This afternoon.
I heard a very funny story about Randolph. Sarah McMillan had some guests for the weekend, and suddenly one of them comes in and whispers, Randolph Churchill's in the hall, so they all peer around the door to have a look. Anyway, he's driven up, drunk as a skunk, thought the house was an hotel, marched in and ordered a gin from one of Sarah's guests.
Who's this?
Randolph at the McMillan's. He thought it was an hotel.
What happened?
Oh, he sat in the hall, drank it, left a tip and drove off.
Why didn't anybody say anything?
They're all petrified of him.
I'm petrified of him.
Just like the old man.
I dread what life's going to be like without him. To Papa.
To Papa.
Mama?
Room service.
Darling, Mama.
Darling. Is Randolph here?
No, not yet.
When did you get back?
2 days ago. You must be exhausted, darling. She missed the early train, so she can't be that exhausted.
How's your father this morning?
He seemed more interested in seeing Christopher than us. It was frightening last night. Why? What happened? That nurse saved his life.
No, no. He just had a little trouble breathing, that's all.
I don't know what Christopher's doing. Duncan doesn't even know that Papa's ill.
He was told with the cabinet this morning. But it's important that we keep this to ourselves.
What about the papers?
Your father spoke to Max last night. Don't get crumbs on the bed, darling.
Oh, sorry. Oh, I love Mrs. Lacey's marmalade.
I want best behavior, everyone. Your father must not be upset. Not when he's like this. I will have no raised voices in this house, understand?
I gave a professional medical opinion, not a party press release that you can fiddle with like some grubby little...
There is what?
The disturbance of the cerebral circulation. That is the phrase I used.
This felt to be too strong politically.
Felt by who?
By you? Politicians.
The Prime Minister has had no respite for a long time and is in need of complete rest. Well, it's a piffle. It's no news that the Prime Minister has been overdoing it. He's been overdoing it his entire life. If you want the Daily Mirror to smell a rat, well, here's the cheese. Is that funny?
Such a silly thing to say. Cheese!
This is what Butler and Salisbury wanted to put out.
Well, I disassociate myself completely. It misrepresents my professional opinion.
Where are you going?
Pressure.
This is from President Eisenhower. Dear Winston, I am deeply distressed to hear your physicians have advised you to lighten your duties. I look upon this as a temporary deferment of our meeting in Bermuda. Your health is of great importance to the world.
Sir, our son, Millie.
What do you mean?
Eisenhower.
Ike, you never wanted the conference. He doesn't believe that we can talk our way to peace with the Russians.
Say it again.
Eisenhower.
And again?
Eisenhower.
Leave that, we haven't finished.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I don't imagine you'd like one of these.
No, thank you.
What's your name?
Nurse Appleyard.
What's he calling you?
Millie.
Millie. Yes. I suppose you're in love with him. This house is normally crawling with Millies, all busy with their little fantasies.
I should take this to him.
I'm sorry. Don't be embarrassed.
I'm not. But I should take this to him.
Did you ever think of getting divorced?
That's quite a question to ask your mother.
Sorry.
I did think of not marrying him. When I finally accepted his proposal, he promised he'd keep it a secret until I told my mother. Within 5 minutes, he told his whole family. I realized then that it was always going to be all about him.
And it's mortal to have this on the fifth ball of his over. Need to push that towards the pavilion end. And the umpire signaling a four. For those of you who've just joined us in the second test here abroad, the sun is shining on a capacity crowd.
Hello?
England took a single wicket this morning, just before.
Hello?
The
Hello!
Randolph. Good of you to come.
Why are you thanking me for turning up to my father's deathbed? How's Eden?
It's touch and go.
Well, why don't I know about this? Why doesn't the party know the two pillars of government are down?
The situation is being handled.
Bugger, is it? It's being sat on by greasy little margarine eaters like you. Why is the house so silent?
Your family are in the garden.
Okay, you can go now. Enjoy the cricket.
Hello, Randolph. Your father's very tired. I've just been with him. Could you wait until he's slept a little?
No.
Sir, he's too tired to see anyone at the moment.
I'd like to be alone with him now, please.
He needs to rest.
You don't know who I am, do you?
I don't care if you're the Queen of Sheba. You're not going to disturb my patient.
I'll sit. I shan't say a word. Has he been asking after me?
Are you Randolph? Yes, he has.
Marriage is like a garden. You have to work it through the winter, and you don't get that gorgeous month of rhododendrons in May. 3 weeks of... Well, I trust you're appreciating the metaphor.
I've sometimes felt more married to him than I have to either of my husbands.
That's silly.
No, it's not. There is no hiding from the world who my father is.
So when did you get down?
About an hour or so ago. It seems quite peaceful. Colville was being preposterous, of course.
Well, he's just doing his job.
Ah.
It was simpler when we were children. But the minute we have our own ideas, our own lives, and we stopped worshipping him, everything changed.
He loves you. He loves all of you.
No, he loves you because he needs you. I don't know how much he needs the rest of us.
So. Mrs. Lacey has gone to great trouble in the last 2 days.
Thank you, Mrs. Lacey.
Well done for doing your job.
Do you have to be so rude, Randolph?
I think it'll be easier for everyone if he dies. Sarah can go off and marry any old lowlife she likes. It'll be easy for you. You can move out of Downing Street. You can sell this place, which you hate, and you can bugger off to the South Bronx.
That's a wicked thing to say about your father.
I love my father. It was a wicked thing to say about you. Got it right, dear.
All the opportunities he's given you. All the times he's helped to campaign for you.
Not that you needed any help losing elections, Randolph.
And I suppose because you've actually appeared in a couple of films that no one's even heard of, makes you an authority on success.
Sarah received very good notices for her television show.
We've all seen the notices of Sarah in America, drunk in the street.
Be quiet, Randolph.
Brings disgrace on Papa.
Mistakes reflect on me, not on Papa.
You really are sick.
Everything we do reflects on him. Everything he does reflects on us. We're moons to the big planet. We're one being. And now, with him sick in there, and sick and dying, with him near the end.
I promised myself I would not cry in front of you people.
That's enough drink, Randolph.
I'd really like to see you try and stop me.
I know you would.
You never stopped him drinking, did you?
No, you just sit by. You sit by, that's what you do. And you watch the disasters unfold like the lives of these two intellectuals.
Don't be so foul.
Oh, Mrs. Soames, shut up, Mrs. Soames. And then you have the audacity to say, well, I'm a good mother. I'm a good mother. What else could I have done?
Randolph, please. None of this is Mama's fault. You can't blame her.
Isn't it?
Oh, Diana, don't.
Because she could have mothered us, only she was too busy mothering Papa. He was her surrogate baby.
And how is your psychoanalyst, Diana?
May I go and visit him?
Not now, madame. Look, here's the proof. Have you seen the photographs of them? This one, and this one, and, oh, this one. The adoring gaze, almost every picture. It's the way a mother looks at her child.
Sit down, Diana.
No! Children who we marry.
You see what you've done?
Sarah's marriage to Vic, you dismissed. You called him a ridiculous little tinkerbell of a man. That was the man she wanted to spend her life with. Who cares what you think? I don't even know what tinkerbell of a man means.
Means he's a fairy, you're halfway.
That's what she said about the man you loved, Sarah.
Actually, it was Papa who said that.
No!
Well done for remembering something.
Oh, I remember all of it, Randolph. Every bit of it, and so do you. Every bit of criticism, every look of disappointment. I remember every single day.
Diana, this is not the time.
And when is the time, Sarah? When? I've been trying to say these things for years now, but nobody ever listens to me.
I don't care what you say about me. I really don't. Your father is lying next door very sick. Very sick. Have some respect for him.
She's defending her baby again, Diana.
And what about everyone else in this house? Do you want them to hear all this?
Oh, I wouldn't worry about them. They'll love a bit of excitement. They can scribble it in their diaries.
Will you stop fiddling around, Mary?
They know not to keep diaries.
Of course they... Open your eyes!
We need to stop this.
I'll go and find Sergeant Murray.
I think you should leave.
I know you do.
Jock will get you a...
I don't need Jock to get me a bloody taxi!
I think you do.
Oh, it's quite an audience here. Sarah, you can come and do your Desdemona.
Randolph, please keep your voice down. Your father is sleeping in the...
I know where he is.
Randolph, if you're going back to London, let me drive.
Oh. Tell Papa. I love him.
He knows you do. He'll kill himself if he drives in that state.
Are you all right, Mama?
Mm. Go after them.
Randolph, let me take you back.
Get a taxi.
Come on, darling. Come on, don't be silly.
Get off.
Jock.
Don't let him drive, Sergeant.
Another way!
This is ridiculous.
Randolph.
Randolph!
Come on.
Get that gate.
Randolph!
Thank you.
Do you think he heard anything?
I don't think so. Nurse said he slept through. They are who they are. What's the phrase? There's a price to pay for greatness, but the great seldom pay it themselves. How are you bearing up?
I wish people would stop asking me that. Are you hungry? Mrs. Lacey's summer pudding has been shamefully neglected.
I think it was Napoleon who said that there are three different kinds of courage.
Did he know?
Yes, he did. Then I'm going to tell you what he thought was the greatest. He called it the three-in-the-morning courage, when everything is dark and cold and all seems lost.
Winston says Napoleon taught him the dangers of fighting on more than one front. The lesson I don't seem to have learned.
You know what he says? KBO.
Keep buggering on. His answer to everything.
What else is there?
Does it never occur to you that there ought to be something other than buggering on?
None of us would be here without him. And he wouldn't be here without you.
He'd be here, whatever.
No, trust me. He's only flesh and a little bone. You're his rock. He knows that. He always has.
He stood and heard the steeple sprinkle the quarters on the morning town. 1, 2, 3, 4. To marketplace and people, it tossed them down. Strapped,
noosed, gnawing his spur, he stood and counted them, curse his luck, and then the clock collected in the tower,
strength and struck.
Brain still works.
I learned it at school, but I'm not sure I could do that now.
The box on the desk, my cigars.
I'm not going to do that.
I don't want a debate.
Good, because you're not going to get one.
Get Colville, will you?
Not if you're going to ask him for a cigar.
Get my secretary. I'm the Prime Minister. I need to know what's happened.
Mr. Colville.
Yes.
The Prime Minister is awake. He wants to speak to you.
Thank you. Prime Minister. How are you feeling?
Get me a cigar, would you?
Of course, sir. It's very good to see you awake, sir.
Indeed. Have you rescheduled Bermuda?
November.
Ah, good.
But that's after Margate, sir.
Good, that's good. We need to start work on the speech.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. Give me a whiskey, will you?
Yes, Prime Minister.
Really, pass me the ashtray, would you?
He's not seriously thinking of going to party conference.
According to Jock, he's already drafting a speech for it. If he is well enough to attend, it'll be a good time for him to step aside.
How is Anthony? Is he fit to take over?
He's building up his strength. He very much wants to.
And there's been nothing in the press?
Not a peep.
As far as the public is concerned, Winston is taking a well-earned rest.
Mary, can the children come up from the farm today?
Of course, Mama.
I want to Chartwell to feel like a family home again. Somewhere to catch him when he realizes he won't be going back to Downing Street.
What I care about now is peace above all. A time of peace.
What I care about now is peace above all. A
time of peace.
Do we have to do this again?
Yes, we do.
I've lived a life like a man who has pursued peace. Have you got that?
Yes, you're a man who's pursued peace.
Like a ferret does a rabbit. You're looking at me as if that's not very good.
Well, it's not.
Mrs. J. Arthur Rank, please. Yes, it's Mrs. Christopher Soames. Arthur! Hello. Yes, it's Mary Soames. Arthur, my parents were wondering, would it be possible for you to send a film down to Chartwell like you used to? That Hamilton woman?
No, we've seen that with him 1,000 times.
Do you have anything more recent, Arthur?
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, I am sure you will be relieved by the news from British Guyana.
I can't hear you.
What?
The Tory party are a bunch of deaf old folk. If I can't hear you, they haven't got a chance.
I'm sure.
What?
I'm sure! Oh, bugger! Look my face now. Where was I?
Just start again.
My lord, ladies and gentlemen, I can't squeeze it, I can't. Why can't I use my right hand?
Don't shout at me.
I'll shout if I bloody well want to.
If you rely on your right side to walk and pick things up, then your left side will never recover. You'll walk like a listing ship. A listing ship. Wash your ears out and your mouth, too.
Are you this nasty at St. Mary's?
Yes, I am.
Ah.
That was good.
Imagine it was you I was hurling. I tried to imagine it was Hermann Göring that did make me angry enough.
Well, it was your best yet.
Millie. You must be careful about pushing Sir Winston too fast.
Oh, it's not me pushing, Mom. It's him. He wakes up every morning with a plan. He calls it action this day.
Yes, he would.
He's a remarkable man, Lady Churchill. That's why he's making progress.
He is brave, yes. But this is not a cavalry charge in the desert. This is age itself he's up against.
He needs hope. I've seen it before. Hope is what makes the difference.
Millie, my husband's ambition runs people over, and it comes at a cost, often to those closest to him. If he fails and gets low, as only he can, it will not be you who has to pick him up. You'll be in Australia with your young man.
Yes, ma'am.
He must be missing you.
Oh, John? No, he's happy. He's on his way.
And when do you follow?
In a month. Although I won't go, not if Sir Winston needs me.
You must be excited.
Well, it's John that's pushed it, really. He says it's full of opportunity.
Well, there is opportunity there.
For him. But I like my job. I'm proud of the NHS, and I'm not sure I want to be stuck on the other side of the world, being just a wife. I'm sorry, it's hard to explain, but the closer it gets to going, the more I think, I don't know why I'm putting his dreams before mine.
Mm-hmm.
You can get that bloody thing out of here right now.
I could always carry you.
Nicholas and Emma have been making biscuits all afternoon.
Oh, how delicious. Did you make them yourself?
Yes.
You live. Who put all the sugar in?
I did.
Good man. And who cracked the eggs?
Me.
Mrs. Lacey, you're out of a job.
Come on, if you could all take your seats.
Let me help.
I hope we're not watching Wuthering Heights.
No.
All right, everyone. Our lights out.
Where's Millie?
Jock, can you see where she is?
What's this one about, then?
It's about an old clock which keeps breaking down.
Is it called Winston?
Miss Appleyard, the Prime Minister's asking for you downstairs.
Is something wrong?
No, he wants you to watch the film with the family. You can stop working for a moment.
You'll want to talk.
Oh. Oh. Sorry, darling.
Is it really serious?
I can try. It'll take hours.
Ambrose! Ambrose, wait a minute! Ambrose!
I need to go to London. It's not in Russia's interest.
Sir, don't do yourself. Sir.
I need to go. I need to go.
Just let me help you.
Was I talking rubbish then?
A bit.
There is no need to tell my wife. Nor that defeatist quack of mine. Growing old is not for cowards.
It's certainly not.
Such a strange thing to happen to a little boy. Have you nursed many people at the end, Minnie?
Yes, I have.
What scares me is getting to the end before I finish.
Hey. L'Attack. What's that one?
That's my colonel.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. I've got two, and it beats your captain.
Keep him still.
L'Attack.
It's a bomb, so bye-bye. What's the next, Jock?
Next is a report on the safety of helicopters.
Not safe, that's obvious.
That's what the report's addressing.
Mm.
Use your left.
No. Your tech.
That's just a scout.
It's better, Winston.
Bye-bye.
I will leave a précis of the report in the box overnight.
Thank you, Jock. There's no point in rushing succession with Eden ill.
Yeah, and if that's the case, well, you'll have no choice but to continue.
Quite right. Circumstances may well convince me of my indispensability. Attack!
That's a bomb. Bye-bye.
Morning, Rat. Jock. How was Greece? I see you got a tan.
It's difficult being in Eden's company and not getting a tan.
When's he due back in England?
A week or so.
Oh! Ah. Outmaneuvered by a five-year-old!
No, use your left hand.
Use your left hand, Papa.
That was a silly
hey.
Shot, Grandpa.
Be quiet.
Will Winston be well enough for Margate? The party wants a public coronation. The king is dead. Long live the king, you know, that sort of thing.
But he's not dead. He's making good progress. Some days he's stronger than others, of course.
He doesn't have to dance and sing. Just pass on the crown.
And there's his pride, Rab. He doesn't want to be seen in a wheelchair.
Foul ball, Nicholas. Take the shot again.
That's not fair.
Ah! Here's the real enemy, Nicholas.
I hope you don't think of me as an enemy, Prime Minister.
I don't think of you at all, Rab. How's my foreign secretary?
Fighting fit.
Jolly good. I expect you're disappointed not to find me ranting in a storm, like King Lear with a lisp.
All I wish is that your health improves quickly, Prime Minister.
I wish that too. Pick up the ball, Nicholas.
Nicholas, why don't you let Grandpa do it?
Well, oh, all right.
Prime Minister.
No, please.
Just let him try.
Get his stick.
Hey. Look at that, love it.
Emma's turn now.
Very sad.
I want you to stop this pretense that you can go on forever.
I have one more task, Clemmie.
Oh, Winston! There's always one more thing.
I could try to make those terrible bombs obsolete before I die. Everyone else has gone. I'm the only one left. Can't my last victory be one of peace?
It's time to stop.
My darling Clemmie.
Don't darling me. I want time with you while you're still you. While I'm still me. The children need time with you.
They're not children anymore.
They are desperate for you.
I begged you to retire after the war. You only stopped because they voted you out.
The people didn't understand.
The people were exhausted. So was I. And I am now.
Clemmy. Clemmy.
You asked me once who is in the photograph by his bed.
The little girl.
Her name is Marigold. It's Marigold's song he's been singing. Diana taught her the words and she was so proud of remembering them. She died just before her third birthday. She'd had a cold all summer. What child doesn't have a summer cold, Millie? But it wasn't cold. It was septicemia. And I wasn't there. They were at the seaside with their governess. By the time we got to her, it was too late to do anything. Winston and I sat with her for 2 days. Neither of us slept. We sang nursery rhymes with her and told her stories. He'd never had the time to tell her stories before. At the end, she asked me to sing that song. And I did. But she stopped me. She was tired. She asked me to finish it in the morning. But that was it. Her last breath is in that song. We never talk about it.
Do you like Henley?
He was Stevenson's model for Long John Silver. I bet you didn't know that.
I did. He was my father's favourite poet.
What did your father do?
He was a shop steward at the Pits. And he was no fan of yours. Mm. Not since you sent the army in on the Welsh miners.
Well, at least he's got good taste in poets.
This one's his favourite. He wrote it just before having his leg cut off.
It's about home.
out of the night that covers me.
Black as a pit from pole to pole.
I thank whatever gods may be
for my unconquerable soul. Minnie, I need some hope.
Good, that's good. Well done. And another. Not too fast, you're fine. Just keep your weight on me. There you go.
Winston? I'm going to take my hands away now.
Dickens used to walk from his home in Kent to London almost every week. Did you know that?
No.
Yeah.
I did. My dad told me that.
Her father's a sort of literary trade unionist.
Oh.
If such a thing is possible.
Oh! You all right?
Yes, I am.
Does it hurt?
No.
Well, let's try slowly. Right. Slowly. Yeah, lean on the stick. That's right. Okay, 1, 2, 3.
Let's get the wheelchair.
No wheelchair! I'm not being carried into the party conference looking like a bloody Maharaja.
What was Winston's mood like when you were last with him?
Winstonian, as you'd expect. But physically, he knows he can't carry on. And he could barely get out of his wheelchair and pick up a croquet ball.
I think he'll be relieved.
You'll have to be firm with him.
Of course.
We've waited long enough, Anthony.
Doc, bring me an unfinished canvas. I want Anthony to think I've been doing this all afternoon.
Where shall I hide the wheelchair?
Put it right here, next to me. Get rid of that chair. Thank you.
I didn't know you painted so much.
My great distraction, really. You know, Turner painted better the worse his eyes got.
So there's hope for you yet.
They're here. Good luck.
Rab?
Jock?
Jock.
You're Anthony?
After you.
Good afternoon, Prime Minister.
Anthony, my boy, thank you for driving down. Come and take a seat. Make yourself comfortable. Come on. It lifts my heart to see you up and above again, Anthony.
Thank you, Winston.
We were very concerned.
Well, we were concerned about you, and it's encouraging to see you're not confined to bed anymore. Mm. July and August can't have been easy for you.
I did not enjoy July, but in August, I believe we beat the Australians.
By 8 wickets, I hear.
For the first time in years, the Ashes will remain at home.
Like you? We should talk about Margaret.
Well, yes, of course. Now, I'll understand if due to your grave illness, you wish to step down. Margaret might be a good time to make the announcement, if that's what you're thinking of doing.
Winston, that's not what I was thinking of doing.
As you were then, Anthony, you and I. PM and Foreign Secretary, the best team.
So in other words, Winston, you got me all the way down to Kent to tell me you wish to continue.
Beautiful countryside, isn't it?
He has no intention of resigning at all. He even asked if I was going to resign at Margate because of my own health.
Did he stand while you were with him?
No.
Well, then, what Winston intends to do is no longer important.
Mm.
I thought Anthony was looking well, if a bit thin.
Clemmy, if I'm wrong and I can't get through Margate, then I'm all yours. That's my promise. If I fall, there's nowhere I want to fall except in your arms.
You've made promises to me before, darling.
I know.
And broken them.
But not any more.
Margate, then. Jock, are all three suitcases in the car?
Yes, they are. We need to get going, Lady Churchill. It's 2 hours to Margate.
Come in. Sir, did you climb the stairs?
No, don't fuss. I know it's part of being a nurse. Tell me, when are you sailing?
On Friday. I've got 2 days in Yorkshire with my mum and dad.
Oh, well, take a brolly. I couldn't have got through this without you, Millie. I've written in it. I thank whatever gods may be for your unconquerable soul.
Thank you. I will treasure it.
Well, I hope this very gloomy-looking young man knows how to treasure you.
He does.
I hope so. Thank you, Mrs. Lacey. I say with great pleasure that I hope not to see you again in a long time.
Come on! I don't know why you're saying such grand farewells. You could be back here next week.
Like the slogan.
Is it one of yours?
He suggested keep buggering on, Lady Churchill, but I toned it down when I passed it on.
Rab suggests you might deliver your speech sitting on a high stool.
I'm addressing the Tory party, not singing White Christmas in a cocktail bar. Onward!
Last month, we did not have quite so big a surplus in our balance.
But in fact, things were a little better than I had anticipated. Because this is the time of year when we purchase our main products on the dollar market. Tobacco, which might be of some interest to some of you. It's certainly of interest to me, the Exchequer.
Where will you be sitting?
Close.
Back. Come on, everyone. Off you go.
Good luck, Papa.
Good luck, Winston. No, switch that off, will you? I got them to put some flowers in here to brighten it up a bit. Ask for these especially. Marigolds.
Yes.
I love you.
Face them down, Winston.
I could face anything with you. The Tories, Russians, even death itself.
Come on.
Working together, achieving these new settlements for public finances, for our financial services and for fairness in Europe, will help us secure
a
bright future for us all. I thought I might just sum up what I feel.
No one expects a long speech. If you feel you can't get through it, just cut to the end.
And I look forward over the coming years to working with you to make that happen.
Good night. Of course.
And so I have great pleasure in welcoming to conference the Prime Minister and leader of the Conservative and Unionist Party, Sir Winston Churchill.
My lords, ladies, and gentlemen.
Have the United States taken before the First World War? Or between the wars, the same interest and made the same sacrifices, and there might never have been a first war, and there would certainly never have been a second. Without mighty aid, I have a sure hope there will not be a third. I'm sure you will be relieved by the new president.
President. By the news from British Guyana. I don't often do that.
Not in conference, anyway.
One word personally about myself. If I stay on for the time being, bearing the burden at my age, it is not because of love of power or office.
I've had an ample share of both. If I stay, it is because I have a feeling that I may, through things that have happened, have an influence on what I care about above all else.
The building of a sure and lasting peace. Let us then go forward together with courage and composure, with resolution and good faith, to the end which all desire.
Go to our website, listen to our podcast, watch video, and more. Churchill's Secret is available on DVD. To order, visit shoppbs.org or call us at 1-800-PLAY-PBS.